CM 365, all about Carnatic music.
I'm very happy that the CM 65, which was basically started for Rasikas, has evinced great interest among student community also. One of the students has asked me about the Melakarta system and what are the rules which determine whether a ragam can be called a Melakarta raga or not. So today I thought I'll discuss about that. The Melakarta scheme as such, the concept got devised around 1550 by Sri Ramamathya, who wrote the Swaramela Kalanidhi. After that we see that Venkatamakhi formulated what we call as the Asampurna Mela Paddhati, which is, I would say, much more complicated in terms of its structure to understand. After this, we have Sri Govindacharya, who brought in about the 72 Melakarta scheme that we see today, that we are practically using now. The kind of the scheme that all of you are familiar with has been devised by Sri Govindacharya. And he also formulated certain rules as to which ragam can be regarded as a Melakarta and which cannot be classified under this. So we look into a few points that he has formulated. The first thing, of course, that he said was that the Melakarta, if a raga has to be called a Melakarta, then it should have all the seven notes both in the ascent and descent, that is both in the Arohana and Avarohana. For example, if you take a ragam like Mayamalagala or Thodi, you would see that they have all the seven notes in the Arohana and the Avarohana, hence they are called Melakartas. Now if you look at a ragam like Bilahari, for example, sariga padasa sanida pamagarisa. Here you saw that the Avarohana has all the seven notes, but the Arohana has only five notes. So that way this ragam cannot become a Melakarta. Another example of the reverse I could give is of Saramati, where you see that the Arohana has all the seven notes, but the Avarohana has only five notes. So thus, this also cannot be regarded as a Melaraga. Now, next point he has devised is that the ragam which comes under the Mela should have the same variety of notes both in the Arohana and the Avarohana, which means that if Shuddha Devata is taken in the Arohana, then return also that ragam should take only the Shuddha Devata. A classic example I could give here is of Bhairavi, which has all the seven notes, but yet we don't regard it as a Melakarta because of the fact that it takes two varieties of Daivata. What I mean is that Sariga Ma Padani Sa Sanida Pa Magari Sa, while going in the Arohana, Pada Chatushruti Daivata, while coming Sanida the Shuddha Daivata. So that way, this ragam cannot be classified under the Melakarta. The next point he said is that the swara should occur in a regular manner, that is Sarigama Padanisa Sanidapa Magarisa. Thus, if a ragam, in spite of the fact that it has all the seven notes, if they occur in a zigzag manner and not in a straight way, then it cannot be a Melakarta ragam. Here I can give you a classic example of Riti Gaula, where you see Sa ga ri ga ma ni da ma ni ni sa sa ni da ma ga ma pa ma ga ri sa. Here, if you put all the notes, the jumbled notes in an order, you will see that it has sarigama padanisa sanidapa magarisa. Of course, not arranged in a straight way. So, but as I said, because of this fact, it cannot be regarded as a Melakarta raga. The next point, of course, he has mentioned is about the ragam or the mela should have the full sthayi, that is from Adhara Shadja to the Tara Shadja, the complete octave. Like example, we see Sa ri ga ma pa da ni sa sa ni da pa ma ga ri sa. Yes, you guessed it right, that was Mayamalagala, the 15th mela. But Janya ragam coming from the Mayamalagala, for example, Nada Nama Kriya, which has got the limited range, which I had mentioned also in one of the earlier episodes. Sa ri ga ma pa da ni ni da pa ma ga ri sa. So where it did not touch the Tara Shadja and does not have the complete octave or sthayi. So in such a case also we see that this ragam cannot be regarded of as a melagartha raga, though we see that it has all the seven notes. So like this, certain rules were formulated to determine whether a ragam can be regarded as a melagartha or not. And based on the permutation combination, we see that Govinda Acharya devised this whole concept of 72 melagartha raga scheme. And he has also challenged the fact that the permutation and combination that he has evolved through this scientific process that he adopted, nobody can probably add even one more to it. So that way we could say that the 72 melagartha raga scheme as devised by Sri Govindacharya is so complete and wholesome in itself.
CM 365, all about Carnatic music.